Welcome back. In this video, I'm going to demo how to use the ADFS application activity report to migrate your applications from ADFS to Azure AD. Here I am in my ADFS server where you can see the applications I have configured with ADFS. Now the goal is to migrate these applications to Azure AD. As we mentioned before, Azure AD offers the ADFS application activity report using Azure AD Connect Health. So you have to install Azure AD Connect Health in your ADFS server to be able to get this report. To get access to the report, let's go to the Azure AD portal here. We're going to click on Enterprise Applications. We're going to go to the Users and Insights preview. And here you can see the ADFS application activity report. Notice that all the apps that I have on the ADFS service are present here in this experience. We offer the unique user count and the migration status for every app that has usage activity within the 30 days. Let's review this application that says additional steps required. So know because an app is ready to migrate, it means that you cannot migrate it to Azure AD. It only means that the admin will need to do an extra review to the configuration to see how that matched to the configuration in Azure AD. So let's go inside this application. So we can see that Azure AD runs some test to assess if the app is easily migratable to Azure AD or not. Let's explore one of the tests. Azure AD is telling us that one of the issuance transformation roles has something that needs our attention. When we go inside, we see that this role, issuance, has a transformation that uses regular expressions to transform the value of the claim to be emitted. Azure AD also tells us what's the alternative or how you can accomplish that on Azure AD and provide guidance on how to follow the instructions. So if we go back to our main list, we can see that Dropbox is one of the applications that it's telling us that it's ready to migrate, since it has passed all these tests that we perform. So how can I start migrating these applications? We generally recommend to start with SaaS applications like Dropbox, because in Azure AD, we have hundreds of pre-integrated apps for you to follow easy steps and configure them with Azure AD. So Dropbox is an ideal candidate to start our migration. So I'm going to switch to the Azure AD Gallery, where we have all the SaaS applications that are pre-integrated with Azure AD. So you can see here, I'm going to search for Dropbox. Here, I'm going to select the application, and then I'm going to click Create. You can read the step-by-step tutorial on how to configure Dropbox. I have already created the application here. So you can see I create the application in Azure AD. I have used some metadata to populate this first step, so identifier and reply URL already. For user attributes and claims, I have made a small transformation to be able to match the identifier used in Dropbox for this application. So if we go inside the user and claims, we can see that to emit the name identifier, I'm actually applying a multiple transformation to a claim. First, I'm extracting the mail prefix, and to the output of that, I join it with this verify domain. Azure AD provides multiple transformations based on regex that you can use to transform those claims. And we can keep adding more and more and more as you require. So let's go back to our main screen. Now that we have configured the Azure AD side of Dropbox, we need to configure the Dropbox side for completing the single sign-on configuration. In Azure AD, you can use the one-click SSO feature to configure Dropbox, so you don't have to follow 20 steps to configure the application. So we're gonna click here, set up Dropbox for business. We allow it. We download the certificate. We click here. Azure AD takes us to Dropbox. And then it gets start prompting us on the steps they need to take. So I'm consenting of Azure AD configuring Dropbox on my behalf. Then I see that Azure AD is configured the application on my behalf. It's asking me to upload my certificate. So I'm gonna upload the certificate. Now, okay to save the changes. Okay. And then once it's completed, it will take me back to Azure AD. So we see that we successfully configured Dropbox. Now another feature that Azure AD offers is the ability to test the single sign-on. So I'm gonna click here, test. I'm gonna see if I can sign in. So it's prompting what credential when I used. I'm gonna use T. Perkins. And now I can see that Azure AD has successfully issued a token to the application. And if I go back to Dropbox, and I can continue here, just recognizing, I can see that I'm logged in to the application. So using the testing experience, I can get this information that was only available using other tools like Fiddler. So now with the testing experience, I can download the SAML request and SAML response in case I need to troubleshoot anything. In the next video, Haro is gonna show you how you can migrate or protect those legacy applications with Azure AD.